If the development in the field of transportation infrastructure is any indication of a country's economic growth, then this assumption is no more prominently manifested than in Malaysia. When Malaysia gained independence in 1957, this was the country's airport. This is the Sungai Besi Airport. 8 years later, on August 30th, 1965, the need for a new airport led to the commissioning of the Sultan Abdul Aziz Shah Airport in Subang, serving a maximum capacity of 12 million passengers per annum. With the rapid growth in the Malaysian economy, the airport had been expanded to a three-terminal international airport. Today, it is bursting at its seams in accommodating 15 million passengers per annum. Further expansion to meet the expected growth in air traffic was no longer feasible. Exerted by the emerging sophisticated needs of air travellers, a new and advanced airport became crucial, especially to a nation accelerating towards industrialized nation status. Began in early 1990. Intensive study was conducted for a suitable site. Eight potential sites in and around the Klang Valley were surveyed by the Department of Civil Aviation. They were Sepang, Serenda, Behrang, Bangi, Air Hitam, Pulau Lumut, Pulau Kari, and Kapar in Klang. Further feasibility studies were also conducted on the suitability and economic potential of these areas. Finally, in June 1991, an area some 50 kilometers south of Kuala Lumpur in Sepang was selected as the site for the new international airport. Measuring 10 by 10 kilometers, the 10,000 hectares greenfield site offered the new airport planners and designers unlimited, relatively flat land. And in the main traffic catchment area, with a clean approach and takeoff coastal airspace, to plan and design an international airport that signifies its strategic economic importance to the nation. In looking at the map, KLIA's strategic location acts as a gateway to Malaysia's bold economic initiatives towards the impending digital economy of the new millennium, the Multimedia Super Corridor, commonly referred to as MSC. Within the MSC project zone are Putrajaya, the government's new digital administrative city, and Cyberjaya, the country's first intelligent city. The greatest challenge to the KLIA project was the time frame given to complete the physical structure and to have the new airport commercially operational by 1998. This has been the schedule of events. 1991, the site was identified. 1992, an environmental impact assessment study, or EIA, was commissioned. That same year, the master plan was completed. 1993, the Engineering Design Contract, or EDC, was commissioned. 1994, the first physical construction commenced. On June 30th, 1998, the airport was commercially open and operational. In February 1992, the government appointed the Anglo-Japanese Airport Consortium, Sindiren Burhad, to undertake a master plan study to maximize its potential for development into a major regional aviation hub. The master plan proposed a build-in modular approach design concept to provide flexibility to accommodate future changes. It also provides for unrestricted operations and rapid and efficient transfer of passengers and baggage. The development of KLIA is to be implemented in three phases. The first phase, beginning with the opening in 1998 and through to the year 2003, will have the capacity to accommodate 25 million passengers per annum and 1 million tons of cargo. The first phase included two parallel runways and taxiways, a main terminal building with contact pier, a remote satellite, track transit system, the air traffic control tower and other supporting facilities such as cargo handling, aircraft maintenance, flight catering, short and long-term car parks, and other auxiliary facilities necessary for the operation. Phase 2 will begin in the year 2003 and through to 2008 with an increment in passenger handling capacity to 35 million passengers per annum. In the year 2008, Phase 3 will see KLIA handling 45 million passengers per annum. Beyond that, the capacity can grow up to 100 million passengers per annum. The cost to finance the first phase of development is estimated at 9 billion ringgit. To finance this multi-billion ringgit project, the government raised funds through different financial papers and loans from local and foreign institutions. To reduce the financial burden, some facilities associated with support services were privatized. This included the ground handling and catering facilities, aircraft maintenance, cargo, and aviation fuel and gas supply. Now that the site has been identified, the government wanted the airport to be in sync with the environment, the country, and the culture. To achieve this, the architectural design concept of renowned architect Dr. Kishio Kurokawa was adopted. Dr. Kurokawa, whose prize-winning designs can be seen around the world, encapsulates his unique ideas under his philosophy of symbiosis, which refers to the interrelationship and fusion between man and technology and between man and nature. What Dr. Kurokawa envisioned for KLIA is an ecological and traditional piece of Malaysia. A KLIA celebrating the arrival of the new age of life. By capturing the ingenious architectronic within the KLIA design in the use of Islamic and symbols components and the green theme in juxtaposition with glass, steel and other high-tech elements. It is a grand display of the symbiosis between Malaysian identity and the cutting-edge technology within the umbrella of the airport. That means passengers arriving at KLIA will experience a dramatic feeling where the tropical rainforest and the traditional architecture amidst the ultra-modern high-tech structure. The desire to build an aesthetically elegant state-of-the-art airport, which will be at the forefront of the civil aviation industry within a tight deadline, certainly requires an innovative and progressive implementation strategy, both from the project macro level for government decision making and the micro level of project implementation. At the macro level, the development of KLIA through KL International Airport Berhad, a newly set up wholly owned government company under the Minister of Finance Incorporated, was an unprecedented move by the government to ensure the required rapid progress of work not impeded by layers of bureaucratic tape. By entrusting KLIAB with a developer's role and overseen directly by a specially set up cabinet committee for the KLIA project, it has not only proven to be cost and time effective, but also ensures accountability through one party.
The critical success factor underlying KLIB strategy to successfully carry out the project are 1. An effective corporate management and administrative strategy with imbued action-oriented teamwork and partnership propensity. Secondly, an effective project and construction management strategy and supported by a lean but dedicated and experienced technical and non-technical professionals as core implement backbone, supported by reliable and experienced consultants. And lastly, an effective and sufficient logistical support.
To cope with the organizational structure demand in the management of the complex planning, monitoring and control functions posed by the challenge, KLIAB implemented the closed-loop matrix organization management approach, a system implemented for the first time in Malaysia for a mega project in the construction industry. Realizing the need to manage new technologies in constructing the facilities and systems such as the terminal complex, the track transit system, the pavements and its material control, the sophisticated electronic and information technology systems or TAMS, and the air traffic control and management system and equipment, the matrix structure requires lean but skillful, experienced and dedicated professionals to drive the project. To quickly mobilize the required personnel for this core team, selected experienced technical and non-technical professionals were seconded from the various government agencies, particularly from the Public Works Department or JKR, to implement the various strategies. This lean core team will in turn manage the services and expertise provided by the numerous local and foreign design and supervisory consultants. Described as one of the most difficult tasks that KLIAB had to perform in 1994, the time-based MIP interconnects all the tendering and construction activities of the entire airport facilities and systems, broken up and distributed into various packages. Accessibility and logistical areas were awarded as early as September 1993. In December of that year, the first earthwork contract was awarded. Given a year to move a total volume of 100 million cubic meters of earth, the earthwork design strategy put in place has made it possible for the Malaysian contractors and subcontractors to deliver the 7,500 acres first phase platform area in record time. Although both procurement and the geographical partitioning and contract packages distribution strategy has provided KLIAB with an effective mechanism. Nonetheless, it has created another challenge in the form of numerous work activities, interfaces, and contractual overlaps that demanded an innovative management of resources to avoid conflict in communication and flow of information that could have resulted in standstill and bottleneck in the interfacing construction activities between the various packages. The closed-loop approach within the overlapping matrix management style has not only ensured unimpeded and efficient flow of information between the executive level, the project unit and the service unit, but has also ensured smooth communication, understanding and progressive working culture and partnership between the different parties working on the project. With a large workforce estimated at about 30,000 converging on site, KLIAB managed to mold and develop a unique working culture and environment for the large diverse working population from 17 different countries from around the globe to work towards one single goal. This in itself is another tremendous achievement by KLIAB.
KLIA gave them all the opportunity to interact, learn from each other, and to work cohesively as a team. It certainly did for me, and I believe that for everyone involved, this project must surely rate as a testimonial of their ability to work in tandem with different disciplines and cultures to meet a common objective, that is, to build a world-class airport according to plan. This is the soft factor that cannot be quantified. It gives us all the winning edge, especially now with growing globalization and a world that is going borderless.
KL International Airport at Sepang is probably the largest and most ambitious single project to have been undertaken by the Malaysian government this century. Through sheer dedication and professionalism, KLIAB has provided the leadership and managerial skill to drive the project to successful completion within the seemingly impossible targeted completion date.
It is the expertise and skill of this group that has made possible the successful completion of KLIA. I can confidently state that with the expertise acquired, we can now utilize these services in Malaysia and in other developing countries. However, to capitalize on this expertise and skill, we need to consolidate and operationalize this core group so that we can go forth and meet new challenges in the growing demand for new sophisticated airports of tomorrow in and around the region as we enter into the new millennium.
With this achievement, KLIAB has set the new KL International Airport at Sepang on a strong footing of excellence for it to soar to greater heights in providing air travelers efficient and unparalleled service, true to its spectacular physical grandeur and sophisticatedness. KL International Airport, Malaysia's gateway to the next millennium.